नमस्कार, सत श्री अकाल, आदाब दोस्तों, स्वागत है आप सभी का वर्कमॉप द्वारा शुरू की गई कहानियों की इस खास मुहिम में, जहां हर खासो आम सुनाता है अपनी जिंदगी से जुड़े प्रेरक किस्से, प्रेरक अनुभव, और उन अनुभवों से हमें मिलती है एक नई प्रेरणा। तो आइए दोस्तों, कहानियों के इस सिलसिले को आगे बढ़ाते हैं और बढ़ते हैं आज की अगली कहानी की ओर। दोस्तों, ये कहानी है सौरभ दत्ता की जिंदगी के बारे में। जी हाँ, सौरभ दत्ता एक एनवायरमेंटल एक्टिविस्ट है जो पर्यावरण के प्रति अपनी जिम्मेदारी समझते हुए इसे स्वच्छ और सुंदर बनाए रखने की दिशा में सराहनीय कदम उठा रहे हैं। दोस्तों, आज हम जानेंगे इनकी जिंदगी से जुड़े तमाम अनुभवों के बारे में, लेकिन इनसे मिलने से पहले और इनकी कहानी सुनने से पहले आइए इनके बारे में कुछ खास बातें कर लें। दोस्तों, ये पर्यावरण को संरक्षित रखने, प्रकृति को स्वच्छ और सुंदर बनाए रखने की दिशा में कार्य कर रहे हैं, और इसके लिए ये अलग अलग यूनिवर्सिटी के छात्रों को भी अपने साथ जोड़ते हैं और उनके सहयोग से ये पर्यावरण संरक्षण से संबंधित विभिन्न क्रियाएं करते हैं। आपको बता दें, इनका जन्म गोरखपुर उत्तर प्रदेश में हुआ और वहीं ये पले बड़े। हमेशा से ही प्रकृति ने इन्हें अपनी ओर आकर्षित किया। ऐसे में इन्होंने करियर में आगे बढ़ने के लिए इसी क्षेत्र का चयन किया और उच्च शिक्षा प्राप्त करने के लिए ये गोरखपुर से पुणे गए। जी हाँ दोस्तों, पुणे जाकर इन्होंने पढ़ाई करने के साथ साथ पर्यावरण को संरक्षित रखने के लिए अपने स्तर पर प्रयास करने शुरू किए। ये वर्तमान में अपनी मास्टर की डिग्री कंप्लीट कर रहे हैं। दोस्तों, ये मानते हैं कि देश के हर युवा को इसके लिए मिलकर प्रयास करने चाहिए और अपना योगदान देना चाहिए, क्योंकि जिस तरह हमारे देश में आज चारों तरफ प्रदूषण फैल रहा है, ऐसे में ये बहुत ही ज़रूरी है कि हम अपने आसपास के वातावरण को साफ रखें, प्रकृति को सुंदर बनाने का कार्य करें। इस नेक काम में ये अपने साथ साथ कई यूनिवर्सिटी के छात्रों को भी जोड़ रहे हैं और सभी के सहयोग से पर्यावरण को संरक्षित रखने के प्रयास कर रहे हैं। दोस्तों, इनके प्रेरक विचार निश्चित ही आज देश के हर युवा को पर्यावरण के प्रति अपनी जिम्मेदारी समझते हुए उसे स्वच्छ और सुंदर बनाए रखने के लिए प्रेरित करेंगे। तो ये कुछ खास बातें थी इनकी जिंदगी से जुड़ी। आइए अब हम मिलते हैं एनवायरमेंटल एक्टिविस्ट सौरभ दत्ता से और सुनते हैं इनकी सफलता की ये प्रेरक कहानी सिर्फ और सिर्फ इनकी अपनी जुबानी।
आई एम सौरभ दत्ता एंड आई बेसिकली आई वुड से माय इंटरेस्ट एंड माय वर्क लाइज इनटू एनवायरमेंटल सस्टेनेबिलिटी। एंड व्हेन आई से एनवायरमेंटल सस्टेनेबिलिटी, माय आइडिया एंड माय पर्टिकुलर आई वुड से force into it would be through or with the help of youth, especially from universities and colleges. So my particular, I would say, environmental awareness or environmental actions are mainly streamlined with help of students from various universities. So I'd been fortunate enough to connect with students from universities like Ferguson, from MIT, universities from Delhi, Gorakhpur, and some universities like SRM from the southern region. So the idea behind this, or how I particularly started with it, was majorly when I was into my bachelor's and I had this particular urge, and I would say the belongingness towards the nature or belongingness towards the environment, which is particularly around us, which we often tend to ignore nowadays. So, but certainly I realized that yes, something has to be done, and who could be the better ones, I would say, apart from the youth, because now the responsibility is upon us, how we take upon things and how we secure it for our particular, not just for our coming generation, but also for our own generation, to particularly cherish and enjoy the beauty that has been given to us by the nature. Particularly, my role model here has been, I would say, not a particular role model as such, but I have number of them who have particularly shaped me, I would say, towards having this urge or towards having this, I would say, capacity to start working and start doing something in terms of the environmental sustainability. So for me, it is like I have Dr. Rajendra Shinde, who is again one of the UNEP directors. He who was like in Paris for almost 20 years and had successfully, I would say, implemented the Montreal Protocol, and based on which he was also awarded with the Nobel Peace, I would say, award jointly with Al Gore. So he's one of my inspiration because I see him as particularly a person of commitment and who has been always inspiring. And certainly I was fortunate enough to work along with him, and which certainly helped me today, whatever like I have done or with whatever I'm about to do in the coming times. Again, we along with him, like there have been number of other, I would say, people who have certainly helped me in shaping what I am today. Again, one of them is one of my professors at university, Professor Sudhir Gavane, who is now the Vice Chancellor of, again, University in Aurangabad. And he introduced me to how SDGs are, and particularly why the youth has to take these things up and work towards the environmental sustainability. Yeah, I have these couple of, I would say, my role models whom I envision, I would say, in a way, towards taking steps or taking necessary actions with help of, again, the young minds and young people like me towards the betterment of the coming future and the planet. I was born and brought up in Gorakhpur, Uttar Pradesh, and particularly my family hails from West Bengal, but for me, my birth and my, I would say, entire childhood has been spent in the city of Gorakhpur. And yes, because being not a very tier one city, so we had this, we have seen particularly the particular city developing, and what also in a way, I would say, has pushed me towards going to the profession or towards the, I would say, future that I am into. It is also because I've seen the degradation of the environment happening in my city. And when I say degradation of environment, so I would just like to point a small thing here, like there is a huge water body, like which we say wetland, right at the center of the city. And I've seen that wetland dying, and certainly in a way all covered up with water hyacinth, allowing no biodiversity to flourish over there in the coming times. That made me more into going towards this environmental sector and start taking actions towards these degradations that had been happening and which I have seen in front of me. So that is how my interest started developing. Although being from a small city, the thing was like we didn't have options in terms of what could be done in terms of our education background towards it. Because we all know, like from smaller cities, it is either you do engineering, either you do doctor, or you go into a profession of like a CA or CS something. So that was very confined, but certainly it opened up, the opportunities opened up for me as I came down to Pune. So for my higher educations, yeah. So particularly, I would say what I personally believe is what can take us or take anyone, I would say, it is not just for personally me, but take anyone to whatever the desired goal or the desired, I would say, want they have, is to have a sincere and dedication towards whatever. It could be a very small thing. For example, it could be like, for example, take up a river patch and you start cleaning it. You need a dedication and consistency. Unless and until you have that consistency with you, you cannot make an impact anywhere or in any way. So my particular, I would say, success mantra, or I would say my idea in a way behind this, has been particularly to have dedication and to have like consistency in terms of whatever I had been doing over the years. And that is what actually takes us far off in life and also far off in whatever we are trying to achieve today in our like career or in our particular in long term, like whatever we want to achieve as a person also. Yeah. Particularly for young climate activists who are coming into, I would say, or who are certainly having this understanding of how and why we need to actually get up now and start, I would say, taking actions, is particularly like, certainly, I would say, now we need to also, the activism has to be again backed by the scientific understanding, the scientific studies that are being done globally. And now that we have access to open data, I guess COVID has made this quite easy and convenient for us of forgetting access to the data that is all available online now. So this open data is one of the most important aspect, I would say, when it comes to like activism or the open data, I say. So open data is the scientific data that is available. So my idea is, or my, I would say, mantra for this activism is particularly, it is not just where we take up a placard and we start protesting, but it should be something which is backed by scientific understanding, which is backed by scientific studies, which is again backed by research papers being done by the very experts who are into the field and who are actually encountering it in person. So yes, so my idea would be have an understanding, not just in terms of the perspective of people, but also in terms of the perceptions coming out of the scientific studies that are going on, so that we can make a solid point to the government, we can make a solid point to the local bodies, we can make a solid point to our universities, we can make a solid point to the companies. So yes, I would say all our understanding has to be backed by a scientific study. And that would be my, I would say, core suggestion, or I would say a core idea that has to be certainly taken up by the young people like others who certainly are coming into it, because I think there is a sheer need now why these young climate activists need to come to the ground, because as we all know, the condition that is prevailing and where the world is moving now. So it is now, we don't have time to just talk, but now it is time to walk along the talk that has been going around. Yeah, particularly every time it couldn't be the way things go on in a very similar pace. So there are ups and downs, and that hits all of us. So it could be now or it could be at a later stage. But yes, I've also seen number of these ups and downs coming, whether it also in terms of my work, also in terms of my career too. So yes, it all, I would say, is part of life. And for me, it has been like, if I share my like educational background a bit here, so currently I'm pursuing my master's in environmental, in ecology, society and sustainable development from MIT Pune here. And prior to it, my education has been into, I would say, commerce. So I was a student of commerce. I did my bachelor's here in Pune under Pune University. I did my master's in commerce from Symbiosis Pune. So now shifting to particularly a different field, I would say, was something shocking for my family, shocking for my parents, who were a bit resistant towards me going into this particular sector. Because yes, as I mentioned at the start, like for people like us coming from a small city, we know only engineering, we know only like doctors, we know other professional careers. So this is not something which usually is supported. So that was a sort of tough time for me to take a call whether I should go for this, because I had that urge of getting the scientific knowledge, getting the scientific understanding of what I'm doing, because I had been certainly active throughout my bachelor's and my first master's, but I certainly realized we need a scientific understanding so that we can prove our points in a more strengthened and in a more formalized manner wherever we are taking our, proposals to. So that was a sort of a very tough time for me, I would say, where I had to, in a way, I was fortunate enough to get a good placement also from my university, but certainly I had to reject all those, I would say, opportunities and move forward again towards this master's course for which I'm enrolled into now. And yeah, that was a very tough time, but certainly with time, my parents realized, and certainly my family realized, no, this is something going good on with me. And that would again not just help, I would say, me in terms of having a better career ahead, but also being a better person in coming times. So yes, so there are ups and downs which would certainly come. We have to take some difficult and I would say very tough calls in life where things might go in your favor or might not go in your favor. But yeah, we need to keep working. We need to keep pushing ourselves. And that is how things go on. And that has been also with me. So nothing, I would say, in a way, which is unusual. That is, this is just a normal, I would say, pace or normal way how our life goes. And yes, that has been also with me. Yeah, for me, I have been engaged mostly with, I would say, students from universities and colleges. And also considering the time now when we have this, I would say, the situation of COVID, which has certainly impacted a lot of our mental health, is quite, I would say, evident now among the society and especially among the youth now. So for me, what I personally follow is like, because I have this particular love and belongingness for the nature, I have this, I personally like spend most of my time being around the nature. So whenever I'm not working or whenever I feel like I need something like which keeps me motivated, so I just take up my camera, I take up my binocular, I go out, get some good photographs of the beautiful, the nature that is providing us with the trees, the beautiful, I would say, butterflies, the insects that are there, the birds. Because if you see, these are the very small creatures, but the ecological importance or the importance that these each and every creature has, whether it being a dragonfly, whether it being, I would say, a bird like a peacock or a bird like kite. So each one of them have a very unique and a very evident importance in getting the whole cycle of the ecosystem going. So everything is interlinked. So what I personally do is, because what makes me feel more relaxed or what makes me feel more, I would say, clear on my head is particularly going out in the nature, seeing, observing the interactions that are going on among the various species which are there, the interaction among the various, I would say, ecosystems, the beauty of those ecosystems. You see grasslands, you see ecosystems like oceans, you see ecosystems like hilly mountainous regions. All of these ecosystems, all of the species have a very unique feature. And just observing them makes you feel so much relaxed and peaceful. Like that certainly helps me out in like getting, or I would say attaining, the mental peace, as we say. And so why I'm telling this more emphasized is certainly because in COVID, when all of us were locked down, we didn't have this opportunity to go out. And that was also in a way a very tough time for me because I couldn't go out. And because for someone who likes to be in the nature, who likes to be in the forest, or who likes to be in the various ecosystems around, it is quite difficult to restrict them at a particular place. So yeah, that is what I personally follow is for my mental peace. And I would say like that nature has the capacity to heal everyone. So yeah, that is what I personally, this has been my story, I would say, in a way, in a very short and crisp way. And my, I would say, understanding about the society, my understanding about the environment and about the people is certainly which I have gained by interacting with people, by getting people along with me, by getting people more, I would say, educated in terms of the understanding they have. So I'd request, like, for each and everyone who is watching or who will be watching in coming time this video, like, get along with people, take initiatives, start doing it small, and eventually your small actions would be turning out big when you are in the right direction. And certainly, in case anyone wants to get in touch with me, I'm there on the social media. I'm there on, I would say, other platforms too. So you can get connected with me on Facebook. On my ID would be Saurabh Dutta. You can like just search around. Or you can also connect with me on Instagram. My ID would be Saurabh Dutta 0551. So that would be my Insta ID. So you can connect with me and we'll make sure like we make this world a better place for each and every one of us. Yeah, so thank you and thank you all again.
दोस्तों आप सुन रहे थे सौरभ दत्ता की जिंदगी की कहानी सिर्फ और सिर्फ इनकी अपनी जुबानी. ऐसी ही प्रेरक कहानियां रोजाना सुनने के लिए हमारे चैनल को आप सब्सक्राइब करें और बेल आइकन जरूर दबाएं. और दोस्तों अगर आज की ये कहानी आपको पसंद आई है तो इसे लाइक कमेंट और शेयर ज़रूर करें. दोस्तों वर्कमॉब आपको दे रहा है एक सुनहरा मौका अपने विचारों को व्यक्त करने का, अपने अनुभवों को साझा करने का और अपनी ज़िंदगी की कहानी देशवासियों तक पहुंचाने का. तो आइए और जुड़िए आप भी इस मुहिम में हमारे साथ और अपनी कहानी से दीजिए सभी को एक नई प्रेरणा. लेट्स इंस्पायर टुगेदर, वी कैन, इंडिया कैन. जी हाँ दोस्तों, आपकी कहानी में ताकत है लोगों का जीवन बदलने की. तो सुनाइए अपनी कहानी और ले आइए लोगों के जीवन में आशा की एक नई किरण. कीजिए सभी को इंस्पायर. फिलहाल वक्त तो चला है आप सभी से इजाज़त लेने का, लेकिन बहुत जल्द एक बार फिर होंगे हाजिर एक नई कहानी के साथ. तब तक के लिए आप बने रहिए हमारे साथ, देखते रहिए कहानियों का हमारा ये खास कार्यक्रम और लीजिए हर नई कहानी से हर दिन एक नई और सच्ची प्रेरणा. नमस्कार.